indices we can do some examples. Here's example 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8 and 9. So start from example 1. Because we're multiplying these terms, so we use this multiplication rule. Basically we add the powers. So we have 1 plus 3 plus 7. So the answer is y to the power 11. Similarly here, this time we're adding fractions, is half plus 1/3. So we can cross multiply, so it's 3 plus 2 on the top and 2 times 3 on the bottom. So the answer is 5 out of 6. So therefore y to the power 5 over 6. Example 3, this time we're dividing, so the divisor has a power 12, so we subtract 12 from 10, so the answer is going to be y to the power minus 2, which can be written using this rule here. Negative indices is 1 over y squared. Example 4, this time we're going to subtract half from 2/3. So we can write that as 4 over 6 minus 3 over 6, so that's 1 over 6. Example 5, we're going to use this power rule or power of power. So basically you multiply those two powers. That means this 3 belongs to this 2. At the moment 2 has power 1. So it's going to be 2 to the power 1 times 3. And then y to the power 5 times 3. So this is 2 to the power 3, which is 8. Then y to the power 15. Similarly here, we got 64 to the power 1 times 1/3, then y to the power 3 times 1/3. So this is cube root of 64, which is 4y. Now this fraction is raised to the power minus 2, so the trick is we write upside down this fraction, then we change this negative power to positive. Now I'm just square the top, 9y squared, square the bottom, 16x squared. This time 16 to the power 1/4, y to the power 12 times 1/4. So the 4th root of 16 is 2, then y to the power 12 times 1/4 is 3. So the answer is 2y cubed. Example 9. So we have a 16 to the power 3 over 2 on the top, 25 to the power 3 over 2 on the bottom. This means we take the square root, then this 3 mean we cube it. Similarly here, dividing by 2 here means take the square root, then 3 means cube it. So this is 4 cube, this is 5 cube. So the answer is 64 divided by 125. So suppose we have 8 to the power 2/3. This means take the cube root of 8, then square it. So that would be 2 squared. So the answer is 4. So if we have 25 to the power 3 over 2, as we've done before, take the square root first, then cube it. If we have here 27 to the power 2/3, this means cube root first, then square it.